Hello and welcome to St. Andrew Institute of Technology and Management, Gurgaon. This is online lecture series. I am Rohit Raj from Civil Engineering Department. We are discussing geomatics and aerial surveying, which is included in your fourth semester syllabus. This is fourth lecture of this course, and today we'll discuss few problems based on strength of figure. Before that, let's try to remind what we have studied till now. Okay. Why we require strength of figure? Basically, we need to identify whether the triangle is well conditioned or not. For this, we'll find out the strength of figure. In normally, we'll use shapes like we'll use equilateral triangle, which is ideally best well-conditioned triangle. In case of isosceles triangle, the angles of base should be 56 degree 14 minute for best shape. Okay. Now, another thing you have to keep in mind that maybe generalize that any triangle having angle less than 30 degree or more than 120 degree, any angle of any triangle having value less than 30 degree or more than 120 degree would not be a well conditioned triangle. You just remember this as a thumb rule for identifying whether the triangle is well conditioned or not. Okay, now we'll see strength of figures. We have studied this equation where L square is the square of probable error. Okay, and D is the probable error of an observed direction. Okay, this point you have to keep this in mind. What is this? This is probable error of an observed direction. Now, another term is this R. R is basically a term that represents shape of figure. Okay. And how R can be evaluated or calculated? That is D. That is capital D. Here it is small d. That is probable error of an observed direction. Now, for evaluating R, we use this relation, that is capital D minus C divided by D whole multiplied with del square A del square B plus del A del B. Okay. Now what are del A, del B and del C? We have studied earlier. This is the difference per second in sixth place of log. We'll see in our numericals that will be easy. Then it will be easy to understand. Okay. Now what is C? C is basically the geometric conditions of sides and angle. Okay. C is calculated using N, N dash, S and S dash. What are they? N is total number of lines including the known side of figure, and N dash is number of observed line in both the direction. Okay. Now what are S and S dash? S is the total number of stations and S dash is the number of stations occupied. Okay. So now we are familiar with each term and we have the relation how to calculate the strength of figures. Now let's see how we'll calculate the value of del square A plus del square B plus del A del B. Suppose we have two angles, that is one angle is 10 degree, that is A. Okay, A value is 10 degree and B is suppose 40 degree, 50 degree, anything. Okay, so what will be the value of del square A, del A, del B plus del square B? That will be 50 degree value here and corresponding to that 10 degree. Okay, so this will be 167. Now similarly, if we have value 30 degree, that is A is 30 degree and B is suppose 60 degree. So what will be value of del square A plus del square B plus del A del B? That that will be corresponding to both of them, that is 60 degree and 30 degree, which will be here, that is 19 degree. Okay, this is the value that we need, or that we'll be using in place of del square A, del square B plus del A del B. That is here, this is 19 degree. Okay, 19. Now we know how to calculate del square A, del A del B and del square B. If examiner asks you a problem regarding this, then there must be this table. Okay, and this would be providing you with this table, and you have to see in a similar manner as explained. Okay, suppose we are in a situation where the values are not in this table. Okay, they are not present in this table, then how will you calculate? Suppose we have a value that is 32 degree or 33 degree or 31 degree, then we'll use interpolation or extrapolation. You can use either one of them. Generally we prefer interpolation. Okay, we know the value corresponding to 30 degree, and we also know the value corresponding to 35 degree. Then we'll calculate using interpolation. We'll calculate the rate of change. Okay, how we'll calculate? We'll calculate rate of change by subtracting 14 and 19, and then we'll calculate, we'll divide by 35 minus 30. That will be rate of change. Now we'll add the value that we have to increase. Okay, suppose we have to find out 32 degree. So two extra. So we'll calculate what will be the change for 2 degree extra. So we have calculated earlier the rate of change, will multiply with 2, and then we'll add it into 30 degree. Okay, and we can also do this by subtracting it from 35 degree. Okay, by subtracting it from 35 degree or adding it into 30 degree, depending upon whether we are starting from the value of 19 or 14. Okay, so this is basic rule of interpolation. I hope you all understand this, or you have studied this earlier in previous classes also. Okay, now we'll go through problems. Let's begin. Okay, so let's start our first problem. It says if the probable error of direction measurement is 1.20 seconds, compute the maximum value of R, the desired probable error for first case, that is 1 in 20,000 and second 1 in 10,000. First of all, what are the given? Okay. In question, it says the probable error of direction measurement. If you are able to remind what we have studied here, that what is the probable error of direction measurement? That is small d. Okay, so it is given here, that is small d is given as 1.20 seconds. Now, what is this? The desired maximum probable error. Okay, desired maximum probable error, that is 1 in 20,000. What is this? This is the probable error given. Okay, desired maximum probable error, that is given here. Okay, but we have to calculate that in the sixth place of log of any sign. Okay, sixth place of log. So how we'll calculate in the sixth place of log? Okay, we have given that 1 in 20,000. So we'll calculate the log of 1 plus 1 by 20,000. Okay, that will be here, this value. Okay, we'll calculate 1 plus 1 by this much, that is given here. Okay, this much. 1 plus log of, if we say log, then there is automatically the base is 10. Okay, so log base 10 of 1 plus 1 by 20,000. How, why we are using 1 by 20,000? Because it is given there the maximum probable error is 1 in 20,000. So we'll be using this. Okay, 1 plus 1 by 20,000. Similarly, we'll be using For second case, we'll be using 1 plus 1 by 10,000. Okay. Now we'll calculate that this value will be, here it is 0.000217. So we'll shift this decimal to 6 places. Okay. So suppose for in this case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this decimal will be here, that is 21.7. Okay. So this value we'll choose, that is 21. Okay. So this is our value. Okay. So sixth place of log value is 21. Now we have L, that is sixth place of log of the maximum probable error. Okay. And we also have D. So what we need to find, that is R. So we have a relation, that is L square is equals to 4 by 3 D square R. Okay. Again and again, same formula, L square is equals to 4 by 3 D square R. We have the value of L. We know the value of D also. Okay. It is given in question itself. So we'll now find R just by simple relations. That will be R is equals to 3 by 4 L square divided by D square. Now we know the value of L, that is 21, and we also know the value of D, that is 1.2. So we'll place them. Okay, this will come to 230 degree. Okay. So this is the first part of the same question. Okay. Now we'll start second part, but before that, what we have done this in this question is that two important things. First of all, the givens, what are they? We have to understand them clearly, that the probable error in the direction, that is R, we have to understand, the probable errors in direction, that is small d. Okay, we have to understand this. Now, the desired maximum probable error of 1 in 20,000. Using this, we have to calculate L. And how we'll calculate? We'll find the sixth place in log, and that is log base 10. Okay. So we'll find 1 plus 1 by 20,000, and then we'll be able to find this. Okay. So that will arise 21, that will come 21, and then we'll calculate this. Similarly, for second case, we have to, what will here, the value of L will change only. Okay, D is same for both parts. Okay, now we'll calculate L, the sixth place in log. Now we'll use 1 by 10,000. For the second case, it is given here, that is 1 in 10,000. So we'll be using this 1 by 10,000. Similarly, we'll calculate this and we'll come to this result, that is 0.000434. Again, we'll go to sixth place of decimal and we'll get 43 as our value. So now L is 43. What is L? L is the probable error in the sixth place of decimal. So now we know that what is L? Its value is 43 for this problem. We also have D, that is 1.20. So again, we'll be able to find R, that will be here for in this case 963. Putting the value of, in the same relation, we'll use L square is equals to 4 by 3 D square R, and we'll take everything to the left side here. R will remain here, and this 3 will come up, okay, side, and 4 will be here, and we'll place the value of D and L, and L is 43, D is 1.20. So we'll get the results. Okay, I think it is quite easy. Once you'll try to practice by yourself, then you will easily understand. You just go through them, the problem, you just read the problem and try to solve the expression by yourselves. Now, second example is the probable error of direction measurement is 1 second. Compute the maximum value of R if the maximum probable error is 1 in 25,000 and second is 1 in 5,000. Again, same problem, and data is given here. D is 1 second, and we have been provided by the maximum probable error is 1 in 25,000. So we'll follow the same procedure. Okay, we'll first calculate L by calculating the sixth place of decimal. So we'll find out log 1 plus 1 divided by 25,000. That will be 0.00001 74. Now we have to shift to sixth place of decimal, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So for the sixth place of decimal, the value will be 17. Suppose the value here 174, here one another value, if there was then we'll be using total value. That is, if one is present here, then the value would have been 117. Okay, you will understand this by solving more and more problems. Okay, so now we have the value of L. Okay, and also we are having the value of D. Again, we have to calculate R. We'll use same expression, that is R max is equals to 3/4 L square divided by D square. Now we'll substitute the values. Okay, here L is 17 and D is 1. So we'll put these values in the expression, that is 3/4 L square D square, and we'll put L as 17, and 17 square it will become, and 4 into 1 square, that is 1 itself. Okay, so now we'll, after solving this, we'll get 217. Similarly, for second part, it is given that maximum probable error is 1 in 5000. Okay, so again we'll calculate the value of L using the relation that we will find the sixth place of decimal of log 1 plus 1 divided by, okay, here it is 50,000, not 5,000. Okay, so we'll calculate 1 divided by 50,000 and this value will come, you can cross check this by yourself. Okay, this value will become this much. Okay, now we'll find out the sixth place of decimal, that is 1, 10, 100, 10,000. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so only 8. Okay, for rounding purposes, we'll choose 9. You can also choose 8.5, but we'll choose 9 here. Okay, now we know L, and also D is given in the question itself. So we'll use the same relations to find, and the value will be 61. Okay. Let's come to another problem in which we need to find the value of D minus C divided by D. What is this? If you can remember our previous class, then you will remember this term. What is this? Where it is used? Let me show you. This is the expression for finding R. What is R? Basically, R is a parameter that represents the shape of shape factor. Okay, shape of figure or shape of figure basically. Okay, here this term D, C and D. Okay, this when gets multiplied with del square A plus del square B and del A del B, this will become this will give the value of R. Okay, so if we are provided with del square A plus del square B plus del A del B, that we can find out using the table, that is 1.2, which I have shown you earlier. Okay, from this table, if we know the values of A and B, then we can easily find the value of del square A plus del square B plus del A del B using this table. And once we have these values, now we can find the value of R if we are able to calculate them. Okay, now what are D and C in this expression? Okay, so for that we'll come to this portion. Okay, what are D and C? D is the number of directions observed. Okay, D is number of directions observed, and C, we know the expression. Okay, D is the number of directions observed excluding the known side of figure. Okay, you have to keep this in mind, excluding the known side of figure. Okay, now for this question, compute the value of D minus C divided by D for the following triangulation figures. If all the stations have been occupied and all the lines have been observed, that means if the number of lines is 3, then n is equals to 3. This is okay. And n dash would be 3 also, because all the lines have been observed and all the stations have been occupied, means n dash and n and s dash and s will be equal. Okay, so we'll see one by one all the four parts. Okay, first part is a single triangle. Okay, now this is the triangle, that is figure 1.11. okay, in this triangle first we'll find C. How we will find C? We have the equation, that is C is equals to n dash minus s dash plus 1 plus n minus 2s plus 3. We have studied this so many times, that the relation, this relation, okay, this we know. Now what is this? This is the expression for calculating C. Okay, where n is number of total number of lines and n dash is number of lines observed in both direction. Similarly, s is total number of stations and s dash is stations occupied. But here in our problem, it has been mentioned that for all the cases, all stations have been occupied and all the lines have been observed in both directions. So here the value of n and n dash will be equal. Similarly, the value of s, that is stations and stations occupied, will be equal, because all stations have been occupied and all lines have been observed in both directions. Okay. Now, for this figure, what are the number of lines? Okay, you can clearly see there are three lines, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, and for them, well, put the value n is equals to 3 and n dash is equals to, say, 3, because all the lines have been observed in both direction. Again, we'll put the value of s as 3, because the number of stations are 3, 1, 2 and 3, these three stations, and all of them have been occupied as given in questions. So s dash and s both are 3. We'll put them in this equation and we'll get the value n dash is equals to 3, s dash is equals to 3. This will cancel out, 1 will remain over here, and n is equals to 3 and 2 s is equals to again 3. So this will become minus 3 and 3, that will be 0. So this part is 0 and only this part will remain as 1. Okay, so value of C will be 1. Now, this one you have to remember, or you have to keep this in mind, the rule for finding out capital D, that is the number of direction observed excluding the number of side. This can be evaluated using the relation, that is 2 into number of lines minus 1. 2 whole multiplied with the total number of lines subtracted with 1. Okay, for this case total number of lines are 3, so this will be 3 minus 1 multiplied with 2, that will become 4. Okay, suppose there would have been there is quadrilateral, then we'll subtract 4, we'll subtract 1 from 4, the total number of lines there will be 4. So this will become 4 minus 1, 3, and again multiplied with 2 will become 6. Now we have the value of D, that is capital D and C. So we'll find out the value of expression D minus C by D. Okay, 4 minus 1 divided by 4, that is 0.75. Okay, again for second part, here the number of lines are 6. How they are 6? 1, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay. And number of stations? 1, 2, 3, and 4. Only 4 stations, 6 lines. And by the question, by default, and dash and as dash will be 6 and 4, because all stations have been occupied and all lines have been observed in both directions. Now we'll find C using that relation, that is n dash minus s dash plus 1, that will become 6 minus 4 plus 1, that will become 3, and s minus n minus 2s, n minus 2s plus 3. Okay, so this will become whole 4. Okay, 8 minus 6, here it will become minus 2 plus 3, that is 1, and from here we have 3. Okay, so this will come to in total 4. Okay, now we know the value of C. Now we have to find the value of D. How we'll calculate the value of D? You have to remember same rule for every side. Okay, that is 2 times number of lines subtracted with 1. Okay, so this will come here, 2 into 6 minus 1, that will become 10. Now we can calculate this expression D minus C by D, that is 10 minus 4 divided by 10, that will become 0.6. Similarly, you can calculate, you change here will be that one new station is here in this figure. So number of lines will also increase. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So number of lines will increase. It will. It is now 8 and number of station is 5. So we'll put n is equals to 8. Similarly, n dash is equals to 8 and 5. Number of stations and stations occupied is also 5. So we'll calculate by substituting them. This will become 14. Similarly, we'll find D also. D, the relation is same, 2 times number of lines subtracted with 1. So this will become 8 minus 1 multiplied with 2, that is 14. Now we'll find D minus C divided by D. Okay, again for this figure we have to count the number of lines, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Okay, so we have 9 number of lines and all of them have been observed in both directions. And now we have number of station as 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So we have number of station as 5 and all of them have been occupied. So n and n dash will be 9 and s and s dash will be 5. So we'll calculate C using the relation. and we'll find it as 7. Now we'll find the value of d. How we'll calculate value d? We'll use the same relation, that is 2 multiplied with number of lines subtracted with 1. That will come 16, and we'll able to find out the value of this expression, that is d minus c divided by d. Okay. Now I think that you are now comfortable with finding the value c and d, and using this relation you can also find r, l. Okay, from with the help of these examples, now you are comfortable with finding out l, r and d. Okay, we'll see few more examples in our next lecture and we'll start new topic there. Thank you. Thank you for listening. Feel free to ask any doubt. You can text, WhatsApp on this number, and you can email using this mail ID. Okay. Thank you.